Hello everyone, today we will see about the for loop in Python. Okay, first everybody should know why for loop is required, where we need set of instructions to be executed for n number of iterations. Suppose example 10 members are there and 10 members have to follow the same instructions, 10 instructions suppose, then we can go for the for loop. So, where you need a number of iterations more, there you can give the for loop. So, we will see the for loop with the example program. Just I am giving one list, I am giving from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Just I have created one list in the name of A. Now I am writing for loop. For is syntax, I am writing syntax for and space, just I am creating one variable called x. It is a temporary variable which is used to access the variables from the list A. Okay, then in is a predefined identifier in the for loop. X in A, just I am giving with the colon, it is a syntax. Next, just clearly note the indent is followed. Next, print, I am giving print x. So here if you see, inside the for loop it is your wish, you can give n number of statements, but just for an example I have given only one print x. X will access the variables from the A. Just we will run this program and we will see the output so that you will understand. This is our program. So wait one second, just I am running Python for test dot py. Can you see the output? It is starting from 0 and it is ending at 5. So according to our list, A is equal to 0 to 5. I have given in for loop, so it is printing the value which is given in the list. We will see one more example here. Just I am typing hash here. This hash will make this line, will, if you give hash, this will be considered as a comment in the Python, so it will not interpret this line. Instead of this list, just I am giving for x in A, just I am removing the A and I am writing range. Range of number 6, and again I am saving and I am running it again, the same program. See, your output is same for this range also, and whenever you have created the list that time also same. So what this range means, this range of 6, it is nothing but it is a predefined inbuilt function in Python. So what this range will do, so if you give a range of 6, it will take from 0 and it will print till 5, which means range of n will represent, it will print the list which is starting from 0 to n minus 1. So if range of n, if you are printing, then it will print 0 to n minus 1. Now we have given range of 6, so it is printing 0 to 5. So with this range function, what and all we can do, just I will tell you. So just I am entering into the Python shell. Now I am giving range of 6. If you give range of 6, it is just giving the list which is called 0 to 5. Suppose you want to print, you may ask the question, suppose I want to print a list which is starting from 3 to 10, how I will print? So if you want to start a list from 3 to 10, from where you want to start, that number you have to give initially. So 3 to 10. So if you give 3 to 10, then it will start from 3, it will print till 9. If you want to print till 10, then you have to give here 11. So this will print from 3 to 10. Suppose you want a list with the sequence 3 after 7 you need, then 7 after 11 you need, then you can give the difference 4. So it will type like this. If you want 11 also, then you go here for 12. So it will print which number you are giving according to this difference, it will print. You can ask me one more question. If I want to print it in the negative number, how I will print? If you want to give it in negative, you have to give from minus 6 comma 6 I am giving. You see the output, it will take minus 6, minus 5, minus 4 till 5. You can give till 0 also. If you want here also the range, like you want numbers in two difference, then it you will get like this. So hope you have understand the range function, how it will be used. You can ask me the question that only we have to use the range. You can use the string, you can use the character, anything you can use. So just I am writing one character B. Again I am writing C and F. So if you want to just run this, you can just give as like old. First I am saving. So you can see the output B, C, F has been printed. So now you understood what is the use of the for loop. If you have any doubts, then you can do comment. And thanks for watching. And in upcoming video, we will see about the break and continue statement. Thank you.